The Kanban block allows you to display your data in a Kanban layout.
To demonstrate how this works, we're going to use an Airtable database that has a table with tasks. Within this table, you'll find fields such as assignee, task description, task name, status, due date, and more. Now, specifically, we're going to be using the project management template that is found in the Softr template library, which you can copy into your Softr account for free and follow along. Let's dive right in. Now, if you have watched some of our previous tutorials on the List and List Details block, you already know that the Project Tracker template is an app that allows you to manage projects and tasks between team members, departments, and offices. So the Kanban block is actually a perfect use case for this, and it's commonly found in project management tools. So let's actually go to Pages and navigate to the Kanban page that's already been created for us. As you can see, this block is pulling from our source, which is Airtable, and the Airtable base specifically is Project Management by Softr, and then our Airtable table is the task table. Great. Then we'll also notice if we pop over to the Features tab, this Kanban block is grouped by status. So as you can see in Airtable, we have the single select status option that correlates with to do, in progress, review, and complete. Additionally, if we pop back over to data and scroll down to conditional filters, we'll notice that the conditional filter is set to show only the task leader's assigned tasks, as you can see here. So if we pop back over to the data tab and scroll to the bottom, you'll see under conditional filters that we have a conditional filter set to only show the tasks that are assigned to the logged in user. And we've done that by using the logged in user's first name condition. So if all goes right when logged in, Rose should only be seeing her assigned tasks and their statuses. Judith, Olivia, and Billy the same. When they're logged in, they should only be seeing their tasks and statuses within the Kanban block. If you are not familiar with conditional filters, I highly recommend checking out our video on that because it's a powerful Softr feature. So essentially what we have here is a My Tasks section of the project management app. I'm gonna pop over to a published version of the app and I'm logged in as user Rose, as we can see here. What's cool about this is that when the user changes the status within the Kanban block, it actually automatically updates within Airtable. So you can see here, build 5 pages went from to do to in progress. And then design flow chart is in review. Let's move it to complete. We'll notice it automatically updates in Airtable. So this is a great way to manage projects with various users, contractors, employees, without them ever having to touch your original database. Now let's set one up ourselves so you can see some of the key features. Most of the setup, such as connecting the data source or configuring inline filters, is very similar to that of, let's say, the list block, which we've utilized here on this project overview page. So if you have familiarized yourself with the list block, then this should be a breeze. So let's head back to the Kanban block and let's add a new one. We'll head over to Dynamic and Kanban. So if you're familiar, you'll know that this is just dummy data and we need to map our individual fields from our data source into Softr. But first, let's connect the data source. Then we want to connect the Airtable base, which is Project Management by Softr. I put some exclamation points in front of the name so it could easily be found. Then the Airtable table, let's say tasks. Now let's pop over to the Features tab and scroll down to the Group By setting. Here, you're gonna select the field in your database by which you want to group the board items. And group items correspond to the single select field in Airtable specifically. So for this Kanban block that's pulling from the task table, I could choose to sort my columns by status, as was the original template that we just reviewed, or by priority. So let's try priority since we haven't done that yet. So all I simply need to do is choose priority, and then the options will automatically generate for us. So just like the list details block, table block, etc., we need to map our item fields. So I actually went ahead and disabled the photo because really there's no photo that really corresponds with our task table. but this could be helpful if you want to show a picture of content or a picture of an employee, for example. So for heading one, let's choose the task name as shown here. So I'm going to scroll down and find task. Great. Next up, let's choose the task description, which is labeled description in our Airtable base. Perfect. Then it might be helpful to showcase which project it's associated with. So let's actually choose a tag, and the tag can be associated with the project. Great. I'm going to remove label. Awesome. Lastly, let's showcase the status in a tag format as well. So we'll go here and then tag and status. Okay, great. I'm going to hit publish just so everything updates. And of course, I haven't really gone into the design of things. I would probably change the two different label colors to make it stand out. But for now, we're just showing the functionality. Now, lastly, let's pop over to data and choose our conditional filters. As you know, conditional filters work very similarly in the Kanban block as it does in the list block. So for our use case, it could be relevant to configure them so that each logged in assignee only sees his or her tasks, similar to how we did down here. So all we would need to do is add a condition, select the field that we want this condition to apply to. So for this, we want the field to be task leader is, and then we want it to be the task leader's name, because that's the data that correlates with this field. So task leader is logged in users, first name. Let's publish that and then check out our app. Cool, we're logged in as Rose and I'm only seeing my tasks and it's now grouped by priority. So I can see I really need to get these build five pages and design flow charts. Now, if for some reason the priority changes, of course, and I want to put that to medium, it would obviously update automatically in your database. Lastly, let's add a button to each individual card that the user can open and view more details about that specific task. So simply you'll just go to add field, and then you can scroll or type for button. Then you can change the label to say something like view more. Then you're going to click add action. Under Add Action, you have several different options. You can open an individual page that exists within the app. You can scroll to different sections on a page. You can also open an external URL, or you can open a modal, which is essentially like a pop-up. Let's actually try the modal option, as that's a newer feature within Softr. So I'm gonna click Open Modal, and then we wanna select our page. So what we wanna do is open up what is called a list details block that's going to show more information about this Airtable table tasks. So let's scroll back down and find that page. Perfect, task details. Now you have option to choose from small, medium, large, or full screen modal. Let's go for medium and we can see what that looks like. So I'm gonna hit publish and let's take a look at what this looks like. So Kanban view, we're gonna check out the build five pages task. And if I wanna view more information about this task, I'll simply click into it and you'll see here a medium sized modal pops up and additional information about the tasks as well as comments that are related to this individual task will be shown here. There aren't any comments right now because we haven't added any. And additionally, we will create a comments block video so you can learn more about how to use this powerful Softr block. Great. So now you've successfully created a Kanban block that is grouped by priority, showing the individual user's tasks that are assigned to them. And the user also can have the option to click into the task and view more information about it. We can't wait to see what you create. Please be sure to drop into the community forum. Let us know how you're using the Kanban block. Let us know what you're building with Softr and more. We look forward to seeing you there and see you in the next video.